In this video, I'd like to share with you how you can find expired domains, Tumblr domains that are high powered that you can utilize. I was asked to do this in a more concise manner, so I don't want to waste time. Let's get directly into it. The very first thing that you're going to need is you're going to need ScrapeBox. ScrapeBox is a tool. It's very inexpensive. Check it out. I believe it's about $97. With that being said, you're going to need two free extensions that come with ScrapeBox. Let me show you where to find them. Up at the top, go to your add-ons. You're going to need ScrapeBox Alive Check, and you're also going to need the ScrapeBox Vanity Checker. I believe it's down here, right here, Name Checker. So make sure once you buy the tool, you have these two plugins. The next step that you're going to need is you're going to need some proxies. Now, you can use free proxies, which you can use down in here, which is the Proxy Harvester. Or if you want to move a little bit faster and you're willing to pay a little bit of money, you can use shared proxies or private proxies. For this instance, I've went ahead and loaded up some shared proxies that I have access to. Now, once you have the tool open, let me walk you through the process of how you can start finding these expired Tumblrs and then check them and start utilizing them. And I want to get through this as concise and as fast as possible. So let's do this together. So the very first thing is go up to the very top left-hand corner. Once you're in the top left-hand corner, what you will want to do is type in T-U-M-B-L-R. Okay, my mistake, type site colon tumblr.com. Okay, now this is the harvester, so you're going to click the custom footprint, site colon tumblr.com. Inside of the keywords, what I suggest that you do is go out to the online marketplace or online to Google, and what you might want to look at is this. What I'm looking for is a 10,000 word English list. Okay, you, if you're looking for something that's more consistent with your brand or your niche or your industry, look for a different type of list. But for me, I'm looking for mass. Why? Because I'm looking for the most potent Tumblrs that are expired as possible. So let's go in here to the common English words list. What I will do is I'm going to scroll on down and I'm going to get some of these otter words and I'm just going to grab some of these words. Now, once I have these words, the very next step is to head back right over to my tool, and I want to come over here to the keyword section, and I'm going to hit the Control V and paste in those words. I've added 314 words utilizing this custom footprint, and I've added in these particular proxies. Now, if you want to go ahead and add different proxies, what you will want to do is go to Manage, and then what you have to do is click on Harvest Proxies. It'll pull in proxies. You can then test them. However, what I did is I just went over here and I went into Load from File, because I went out and bought a proxy list and I added it. They're shared proxies. Now, once that's done, all we have to do is we need to then start harvesting for these particular Tumblrs. So I'm looking at Bing, Yahoo, Deep Crawl, and Web Crawler. What we're going to do is we're going to start this up. We're going to fire it up and see how many we can start pulling in. So we're just going to give it a little bit of time and then we'll move forward from here. All right, should not take too long. We're doing this together. So exactly however long this takes is exactly how long it takes. Once we actually have a definitive number here, we will move forward. So bear with me here. All righty. So we are starting to run. Ready? Okay. Okay. All right, it looks like it's loaded in our proxies here. Harvesting, errors harvested. Okie doke. All right, now, just for sake of example, we're just gonna go ahead and utilize these 30, okay? So we're gonna go ahead and stop. So I'm not sure how long that took, but I've been able to pull in 37. The next step that I want to show you is this. Once this goes through here, now obviously you're going to let this go through to 100%. You want it to get the full amount. But for the sake of this video, just to walk you through the entire process, I'm going to go ahead and just cut this short at 37. All right, so that way we can get through this as concise and as fast as possible to get to the information. All right, but I want to make sure that it's live. I want you to know and understand what the process is, how long it takes. I want you to see all the pieces. All right, so we're doing this together. The very next thing is once we have this, okay, I'm just waiting for this to get done. Now, note I am recording. Note I have other things going on. So we can go ahead and shut this one off. All right. We can shut this one off. All right. So I'm just waiting for this to go back in. All right. Now we have this full list. What we want to do is we want to go back. All right. And what we want to do is we want to go ahead and hit close. And now this is the list. The very next step that you want to do is you will want to trim to root. So let's go ahead and do that together now. So you will want to go over here to the right-hand side under manage lists. As you can see here, the right-hand side, go to trim and then trim to root. Now what you're left with is a full list of all the different tumblers that we've gone out and we've grabbed. Next, the next piece is this. What we need to do is we want to come in here and we want to go to remove duplicate domains. So now we've trimmed them to root, cleaned the domains. Now the next step is we want to go in here to our tools, and we want to go in here to our add-ons, and we want to head over here to ScrapeBox a live check. Now what we want to do is we're going to go in here, we're going to go load URLs from ScrapeBox Harvester. That's all the domains that are here. And what we're going to do is we're just going to go ahead and check and see if these domains are actually alive. The answer is yes. Great. Now we're going to close this. The next step is once we know that they're all alive, we want to go over here to tools. I'm sorry, add-ons. Scroll down to vanity name checker. And what we're going to do here is we're going to figure out, are these domains available? Are they available or are they not available? So what we want to do is load from the harvester. And what we want to do now is we want to actually start checking these, and it's either going to say it's alive or it's not alive. And what this is going to tell us is, are these available to be signed up for? Now, let's say, for instance, that this entire list, all right, that we grab, all right, because what we will do, let's wait for this to process. We'll give it one last time. Okay, give me 1 second. Taken. Now it's either going to say available or taken. Okay, so bear with me here. All right, so we're going to stop it. And now we're going to say that what's left here, let's just stick with me. What we are going to do is this. I'm just waiting for all of this to process and get done here. All right, because I want to point something out to you. All right, because there's a step here, because you don't want to have to do all the work. I want to show you each of the steps in the fastest amount, concise as possible. Wink, wink, the person that asked me. Got your back, my friend. So let's go ahead and keep doing this. So the next step is this. So what we want to do here is we want to go in here to export all available URLs, the available ones. Now let's just say, for instance, okay, just for fun, that all of these that are left, this is the list that was available, okay? The very next step is if you have access to the Moz API or any other API or a tool where you could check URLs in bulk, or maybe you have access to a bulk checker, much like one of these. Like if you come out here to Google, I'll show you one of them. Small SEO Tools Moz Checker. Okay, let's just use that one. I'm not recommending them. I'm just saying this is just for a quick check. You can come inside of here. Okay, let's go in here. What we're looking for is we're looking for a free bulk Moz DAPA checker. Okay, this is a bulk tool. This is going to be free. We're just looking for a quick test. Okay, and all we want to do is we want to paste up to 20. We can check 20 at a time. And what we want to do is we want to just check their authority, and we want to see, are the metrics viable? Now, let's just say, for instance, that these were available. Now, generally, the DA is going to be lower than the PA, but each of these blogs are standalone properties, okay? Now, if you do some more investigation, as the pages get bigger, you might be able to find more authoritative DAs and PAs, but generally your page authorities that are 60, 70, 80 is what we're looking for, and you want a happy medium. You want like maybe a DA 70 with like a, or a PA, all right, if we're using Moz, we want a PA 70 or 80, and then a domain authority that's 30 or 40, all right? These are hard to find. These have generally been snapped up already, but they do exist. I find them quite consistently when I generally do this and I do a full run, all right? Now, let's just say, for instance, again, we just did this really fast to be as concise as possible because I wanted to get you through the process, but if you wanted to, all right? Now, remember, these are the list. This is the list from the tools. Now, we've done all the checks. We made sure they're alive. We made sure the vanity checker. We've checked their metrics now. We found something that we really like. All you have to do next is you grab the name that was previously there, copy it, and then go to tumblr.com. Now, remember, we're on this list. We know that this one right here, we're just using this as an example. We know that this one's available. We know that the metrics are there. We know that the vanity's there. We checked everything. We did it all. Now we're going to sign up a new blog. Remember, this one's expired. This one's available. It's no longer out there. It's called gamethesoldier.tumblr.com. What we're going to do then is we're going to sign up, and the blog name that you're going to use is that name right there. And that's how you find powerful expired domains, expired Tumblr domains for your usage for other campaigns. You could sell them. You could do whatever you want. My name's Chris Palmer. If you have any future questions related to expired domains, expired Tumblrs, how to use ScrapeBox, anything, feel free. Go ahead, ask in the section below. And I always look forward to seeing you in the next expired Tumblrs, expired domains video. Have a wonderful day.